Hello, everyone. Andy Schwab here from the Northern Ag Network with your morning market report. Well, in light of the recent storms, the Montana Department of Agriculture is reminding producers that when there is a hail loss, it is the participating producer's responsibility to inform the hail insurance program of the loss within 14 days of the storm. MDA says producers can call, email, or slash and even fax in their completed loss forms, and their applications are available through MDA's State Hail Insurance Program online. Of course, producers can insure crops against hail damage at the maximum coverage rate of $70 or $75 per acre for dry land and $114 per acre of that irrigated land. Now, those state policies are available for purchase until August 15th of this year. And a couple of former 4-H and FFA members were recognized as recipients of Montana State University's Top Scholars. Clayton Jessen of Belt received the 2024 MSU Presidential Scholarship based on scholastic achievement, demonstrated leadership, and exemplary public service. Jessen was raised on his family ranch with his parents Corey and Lisa Jessen, as he's planning to study mechanical engineering and business. In addition, Zora Holt of Hinsdale received the 2024 MSU Provost Scholarship with extraordinary accomplishments, hard work, and potential to make a significant contribution to society. Holt, the daughter of Jason Holt and Sierra Stoneberg Holt, that is, was the 2022 Montana FFA Star State Secretary Award and plans to study pre-veterinary science. Congratulations to those recipients for achieving some of the highest honors at MSU and being selected from fields of more than 1,000 students from across the nation. Well, let's take a break, but join me back here in a little bit as we're going to look over your ag markets and more.
I wanted to put up a fence to protect my tomato plants. So I grabbed this and this, and then I did this. But instead of yielding a big crop, I hit a utility line and had to pay $1,200 in repairs. I didn't just lose my pride and joy. I could no longer afford the new stovetop I'd been saving up for. Next time, I'm going to make my free call to 811 before I dig.
Learn from Curry and hundreds of others. Call 811 before you dig.
Welcome back, friends, to your Ag News in your markets. A group of 157 Republican senators and representatives on Tuesday asked U.S. Environmental Protection Agency Administrator Michael Regan to withdraw a heavy-duty truck emissions rule that calls for electrification of the U.S. fleet. The Biden administration rule announced in March this year tightens emission standards for heavy-duty vehicles sold in the years 2027 through 2032. The agency has said that the rule is technology neutral, but essentially mandates the use of electrical vehicle technology, according to the lawsuit filed by attorney generals in 24 states in May. Now, the lawmakers pointed out to a study that found that the rule would cost nearly $1 trillion in infrastructure investment to fully electrify the U.S. commercial fleet. They also said that the cost of electric semi-truck averages more than $400,000, while a comparable diesel Class 8 truck costs around $180,000. And packer interest should increase dramatically today as the holiday break disrupted normal trade yesterday. The extent of that interest should be seen, or is still to be seen, that is, as box beef is supportive of the higher prices, while grilling enthusiasm is likely going to dip due to those higher prices. Of course, cattle auctions in the regional sale barns have been scarce as of lately. However, video auction season is in full swing. This week, we saw strong numbers from Cattle Country's High Plains Showcase that pushed those six-weight steer calf prices anywhere from $1,800 up to $2,100 a head on most of the averages. Come Monday, we're also going to see Superior try their hand at their test with their weekend Rocky sale. Sioux Falls did hold off on their weekly sale for the sheep due to the holiday, but they're going to resume on next Wednesday as well. And grain trade is not going, or they're going to need to find a rallying point, that is, here soon. However, advancing winter wheat harvest in the south and the global wheat prices dipping has added some big headwinds for traders. Spring wheat conditions are also adding to the fears of some leftover stocks that their harvest is going to be kicking off this fall. Well, that's all for our Ag News and Markets. I'm Andy Schwab. Have a great rest of your day.